Vladimir Kirby. However, he has switched his characters a little bit. However, never mind. The man is playing Kirby. This is a hand warmer. No, they're hopping right into it. We got Eva Thunder 111 playing Palutena. Not familiar with this player, but I'm always excited to see him out here.
I'm gonna just call him Thunder.
Yeah, just call him Thunder.
And I'm actually really excited to see. I love seeing uncommon characters on stream. And if you're saying that he's a regular, now we can see Kirby popping up here. Obviously, Kirby, if you talk to the man running the stream right now, needs a little bit of help.
Yeah,
but so he did get a couple of small buffs in, I think it was 3.0.
Yeah, he did. So Kirby, Quang is, if you're looking for New York's finest, he is definitely New York's finest Kirby. This is the guy that beat Locust in 4 at one of the Aeon Locos. A Kirby beating Locust. In fact, this Long Island versus Canada starting to become a more a little more
pretty common
theme
thing
right now. Yeah.
It seems like Long Island is always coming out on top. Right now, Thunder just trying to find his footing. You know, normally you can utilize that short hop there a lot, but you have a short body in Kirby who just ducks down with those down tilts repeatedly. Like, that's hard. You can't utilize the same options. See, right there, Kirby gets to stay grounded. Now what do? You have to throw out your jabs. You have to throw out your down throws.
It's funny you bring it up because that is one of the best aspects of Quang's play. His reaction time and ability to play defensively and really bait out your bad habits is one of the things he excels at the most. You're not going to see this man commit a lot. This man's going to go on to date. He's going to be dating a girl for about 6 years before he puts that ring on.
He's going from 0 to 51 and then cashing out a little bit more as well. And you see he's reacting really well to these rolls, just kind of running back and forth, putting out the up tilt. And that is not... Oh, never mind.
Give
excuse me. I don't know what that DI was, but it's definitely exactly what Quang wanted. And he is currently up 2 stocks over Thunder. We're seeing many potential 3 stocks so far
it's
to start
Long
this
Island, tournament. Strong Island, baby. Like, all the streams, all the sets so far on stream have been from Long Island players that have been really just cooking up right now. Thunder really doesn't know what to do. I'd like to, so on the note of Thunder, there we go.
There
Thunder
we go.
Finally pushing advantage for the very first time.
Finally figuring out how he needs to approach and deal with this Kirby, because the Nair is not really as well like utilized because of the short positions. But those, you just gotta watch out for those trips.
Those down tilts are really lethal. I don't know if tripping still has the same probability. I'd have to get an actual expert to talk to on that one. But I know in 4 it was like a 1-3 chance or something like that. Don't quote me on that, but there is a very good likelihood that you will get tripped by Kirby's down tilt.
I like the fact he went for the roll option there, because the last time he caught him with the down tilt, but that time he's going to get smacked in the face by the Wings of Justice. We got Palutena finally putting a point on the board.
It might be a little bit of matchup and experience on Thunder's part, because to be honest, who's really going to know how to fight a Kirby?
And he went for it again there too. See, now Thunder's going to be worried about this. Like, all right, he went for a roll read twice. Is he going to read a spot that's this time? Because we've already seen him go for the short hop forward air. See, right there, they immediately followed up. It's like I see the patterns that they go for. And it's something that you saw that Thunder held shield for. It seems like he's starting to get a hold of how this matchup is supposed to go.
So one thing I want to see Thunder doing is angling his shield downward. Angling the shield downward is going to prevent him from getting hit by most of those down tilts right there. If your shield does get small enough for a poke to occur, you can just jump away. Kirby really doesn't have that many means of chasing you. Unless, like, maybe a fair, but Kirby's aerial drift isn't the greatest.
Yeah, we are seeing quite the comeback here from Thunder, by the way. He is really starting to realize what he needs to get going. But that up throw at the ledge, that should take it.
This man just gave him the suplex. Quang's also looking like an anime character right now. When, you know how, like, the light, like, the shadows go over their eyes?
Yeah.
Quang's hat right now is making with the... My man's about to go on a safari.
Looking like Luffy in...
I don't know what that hat is.
There it is.
He's on a safari right now, bro.
That is Bugcatcher Bill right there.
He's hunting. That is
actually a Bugcatcher hat.
That might actually be a Bugcatcher hat.
Oh my god, that might actually be a Bugcatcher hat.
My man's out here catching these stocks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, meanwhile, Thunder was making a lot of adjustments. I was very impressed on how he was starting to utilize the down tilts and the dash attacks, noticing that Brother Quang was playing really well grounded, so you have to like understand and play slow and play around that, especially
right.
As a character that you're not used to seeing.
You can't go in too hard on Kirby because Kirby will be able to kind of blow you up. I know it's a weird statement to say, but it is true. Kirby's got great close range tools on the ground to really deal with most of these characters.
And I actually kind of like the shortest stage here, because you saw that Brother Quang was resetting center stage a lot.
Wow. And this man knows the teleport game.
Yeah, he's got the movement.
If you have the movement, but you gotta have the neutral.
Exactly.
The
like all the labbing in the world doesn't matter if you can't get the option open. But he's definitely making a lot better decisions. I like the fact he keeps putting out these down tilts and like forcing Brother Quang to commit. And that's exactly where Kirby struggles. When Kirby has to commit too hard, then he's gonna take a lot of damage.
Okay, not getting him on the platform right there, but Quang doing an excellent job of just holding center stage. That roll behind was great. I want to see Thunder doing that. He's doing that a lot more. I don't know if Quang's going to adapt to it anytime soon, but Kirby really doesn't have a lot of great out of shield behind options. Maybe F-tilt might be his quickest one. I'm not too sure on that one, though. There we go.
Okay, that time, see, he recognized again. He's like, all right, he has one of a few options here. If I don't trip, he's got to go for a roll read, or he's going to go for a short hop fair. This is where Brother Kwong needs to start playing slower now. It's like, all right, I'm going to put the down tilt out. I'm going to wait to see him whiff something and then punish him afterwards.
We're seeing a new signs of life right now. There you go. Was that an angled shield?
Yeah, he put the down tilt out and he backed up to see what Thunder would do now. That's the hard part about playing characters who don't have like good true kill confirms like Kirby, but it seems like Brother Kwong definitely understands how he needs to get those kills.
And I'm liking Thunder's reset to neutral every single time. So when you have a certain, I believe it's 11 hits on your shield, you can roll behind the other player. So if you can trap him in that jab, was it 12? Was it 11? Okay. One of those two. Now it's looking a lot better for Thunder. Now that he's committing far less neutral, as I say that he gets dash stacks right there. But he's been holding his space very, very well. And Kwang has been on the back foot. That being said, though, that SD there might cost
a
little
Thunder
bit.
Was definitely very visibly upset with that one, putting his hand up to his head, after having a nice lead there. But he's still got a very comfortable lead so far here. He just wants to make it so Kwang has to constantly commit, because he knows that Kwang's got the stuff. This throw right here could lead to pretty big damage. Woo. There we go. Only 35% he was able to get out of it after that ulti.
So, I do like to see Thunder committing a bit less, but I also want to see Kwang kind of approaching more. If the bubble's up, he's got to be grabbing.
Well, here's the thing. Remember what I was talking about before, while Kwang needs to, like stay back and wait to see what he's doing? He knew that an option was coming on a jump read there, and he made him whip that F smash. The down tilt to F tilt, not going to take it just yet, though. There
that was
it is.
Excellent there right there. Just waiting.
Wow, still living.
Great DI from Kwang. He's going to make it back past
I didn't ask him that later. Is it Kwang or Kwang?
It's Kwang.
It's Kwang? Okay.
Yeah, there you go. I was going to correct you, but I want to be that guy on stream.
I prefer it. I like to make sure
That's
everybody's
true.
Got their names
yeah,
right.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, Thunder is pretty easy.
Yeah, Thunder hit. Thunder 1-1-1.
Okay, I actually like that option. It was a little bit too late on the explosive flame, but he made it look like he was whipping something, and it would have caught Brother Kwang approaching. Finally catching him approaching on a grab attempt there. Gonna get
That's
that back here.
Every kill that Thunder's been getting this game has been off of Kwang running in. Every time Kwang runs in, Thunder's just able to do a short hop aerial right there to just kind of stuff him out.
And that's why Kirby overall kind of struggles. Like, Kirby has to...
What do you do to approach?
Like, what do you do from a range? You could absorb Palutena and get auto radical. That is an option. Up throw at the ledge. No, down throw, just getting the extra damage, not trying to stale it just in case it's not enough.
It should kill now, though.
Yeah, especially if he gets it under the platform here.
He's waiting. Thunder is pressing a lot of buttons, so if he just waits for Kwang to press them, if Kwang waits for Thunder to press the wrong one, this could be looking a lot better. And this is looking like a completely different game from the first one. Thunder's just taking full advantage of Kwang's positioning right now.
Agreed. And also Thunder, he's playing like a disjoint game. Yeah. One of the things that Kirby struggles with, especially as swords, here's the up throw, that should be it. There we go. Potentially the last stock of Winterside Life for Thunder, or if he can close this out, bring it to a game three.
Ooh, here we go. He's the startup. Oh, gonna get the spot dodge right there. Good DI. You always want to be DIing out, especially if it doesn't make sense, because that back air is a very lethal kill tool. Not going to get it. This is going to be a free punish stuff order. Okay.
Yeah, Kwang was trying to go a little bit deep. That way he can get him potentially on a dare read if he tried to jump a little bit late. Trying to read a jump himself there as well for that up air. Not going to get it.
Kwang doing a great job. That teleport, that was wild.
Yeah, and here's the big thing too. We've seen some visible frustration about a Thunder before. He has to make sure he keeps his composure here, because this is something really early that you can definitely lose it, not getting somebody's kill confirms you're looking for.
So I'm very interested to see if Thunder could actually up smash at the ledge to catch that recovery from Kwang. That up smash is out for about 18 frames, so it's gonna take a while. I don't know if it could 2-frame per se. But it's a really good tool to catch like unsafe recoveries, especially if Kwang is not sweet spotting that recovery. Mm-hmm. One more poke here should spell death.
What else? F tilt at the ledge too. Oh, if he gets a trip, F tilt
down
ledge,
smash,
that could potentially kill.
Dude, one more trip into F smash, I think he might be dead at the ledge.
Hey, see, Kwang has slowed this down so much that Thunder is kind of just kind of swinging. There it is, the back throw that should be bringing.
No, he's not dead. He's fine.
Still in this, Brother Kwang trying to close this out now, because this is definitely not something that he wants to go to game three for. He gets the back air, and that's going to be game number two.
Every kill, we were seeing some great adaptation from both sides. However, every kill that was done on Kwang was from Kwang running in brazenly and getting back aired. I'd like to say maybe start walking a little bit when he gets closer, or just taking it a bit more slowly, because you know Thunder's going to be doing those short hop aerials all day long.
And
he's got to fight
the
right opening.
He was doing a solid job like slowing it down, but agreed, when after he did slow it down, he didn't bring it to like a snail's crawl pace. He was like moving in at him, but then quickly. You got to try and bait more like what he did on the platform, where he threw out the F smash and he called it out. If you could get Thunder to swing a lot more, then you'll be okay. Because Thunder doesn't need to commit. He can just put out hitboxes for days, and you're the one who has to come in. All right, going to game number three here between these two. Rocking it onto Yoshi's.
Now this, I don't know about this kind of pick. I think Palutena excels really nicely on triplats. Quang might have the secret sauce. I think said that down there right there.
I think a big reason why he's decided to go here is more escape options. Palutena does excellent here, but he had to approach very linear before. So now that there's triplats in the way, he can try and shirk a lot more jumps and a lot more early defensive habits out of Thunder. On the same token, though, you got Thunder, who's on the other end, looking to seek early jumps, get those nairs.
If there's one thing, Quang won't be leaving the ground too much, so it gives him more options to escape, but he's going to be hanging on the ground and taking it to the safe mostly. Kirby really doesn't excel from jumping too much in the opponent's face.
I need to recheck Kirby's weight after this, because the amount of kills that Quang has been living... excellent DI too. Yeah, he does eat a lot.
It literally goes
into a black hole. Like there's no carb retainer after that.
He's literally God. So I mean, you never know. Mm-hmm. Trying to get the correct poke right here. See this?
That's got to be super like annoying mindset wise for Thunder too, because I keep getting all these right decisions and he won't die. He's finally gonna get him swinging for that forward throw. I mean, excuse me, forward smash.
Palutena's grab range is one of her best assets right now. Her dash grab ain't nothing too impressive, but her standing grab range is mad nice. You can an opponent's shield grabs in front of you, you can just shield grab them right back if they miss.
Yep. And definitely a miscued forward smash there. I don't think that all was what Thunder was going for, but it's on you have to capitalize every time. Quang got in there, sealed it out very quickly.
You can't be pressing your buttons too hard, man.
I like the baiting movement there, chopping back and forth.
Okay.
I've been trying to go for that at the ledge. It hasn't worked yet. I'm not sure if he's trying to go for it above the ledge. It might two frame. I need to check that.
I'll take his word for it that he's trying to get a two frame or something off of it, because... But I don't know what else he could use to two frame, you know? He could go off stage to try and get the dare, but... With teleport recoveries, it's always very iffy because they're literally intangible.
Something that Kirby's, you don't want them to see too often, but can be a very tricky option, is that he hasn't pulled out the down B card yet. Because at some point, you know that Thunder's going to try and read a jump. And if he throws out a quick down B while he's not paying attention, that kills really early. So you always have to respect that on landing for Kirby's as well.
That's the thing, though. Wow, that's a great air dodge read right there by Thunder. That was something we've seen back, harking back to Smash 4. That is a great, great air dodge read. Quang, see, the thing you mentioned about the down B, though, is that Quang really hasn't found himself in situations where he's landing from that high up above. It's always within the range where Thunder's able to connect some sort of aerial, like an air.
Yeah, he's been staying grounded a lot, too. And he needs to. You don't want to be above Palutena pretty much ever, especially as this character. Trying to read a roll back in there with that up smash, but they're not giving it to him.
And now at disadvantage, Quang is almost forced to approach every single time. If he could just wrap this stock up right here, he's going to be... Look, there we go. Okay, catching that get up right there. Very, very good jump. And a dare!
Oh, and he caught him on the high end, too. We're going into last stock. This is so early in bracket. We have yet another close match between these two.
This is a really close set, finally, this early in bracket. This is the first, game three last stock set I've seen so far.
Yeah, we got a Kirby on screen trying to take out a Palutena early on. I know a lot of people are probably cheering for Brother Quang right now. But Thunder also putting in a lot of work trying to close this out.
Not reading the get up quickly enough there. Now Quang is kind of forced to play neutral once again, getting that trip right there.
So much mileage off those down tilts throughout this whole set.
He's evened up this game. Oh, you can tell how scared Thunder is right now with how he shielded at the ledge right there. The only thing that Quang would have had to do is grab right there. And now Thunder's on the back foot. Quang looking very poised right now to win this.
This is exactly what we talked about in the last game. Brother Quang was doing well in running it back when Thunder was throwing out a lot of hitboxes, but now Thunder finding his positioning. Can he potentially get a down tilt or a near read at the ledge?
Good defense. Quang not wanting to overextend right now.
Thunder and resetting tail side too. He's got to be careful with these forward smashes.
He wins the trade, actually. He gets Thunder off stage. One good read. Not going to quite get it, though.
Good. Wait on
boy.
That.
Up throw?
No, not yet. But that's another thing. That up throw being online with these triplats is so much better. Also, back throw is available for Thunder at this point, too.
Up throw down.
Up throw might take it out. And Brother Quake's going to take it 2-1 over Thunder with a Kirby to start off this early in bracket. What an intense match between these two this early.
What happened there was Thunder got a case of the jitters. My man, when he was in the lat, he wasn't even a kill percent yet. And he started panic shielding right in front of Quang. Every time Quang ran up on him, every time the shield came out. He wasn't just
back.
You have to stay on the move
aerials,
during those situations.
If you get locked down and shield, your opponent, if they're good enough, they will be able to adapt that, especially with low tier mains who are so disciplined.
And every time
like
that
Quang.
Thunder had a good advantage, he was putting hitboxes out, because when you have a character like Kirby who's just all brawler, there's nothing
right.
else to it,
yeah.
you have to approach. And every time he had those hitboxes out, Thunder could have get around it. But the moment he was forced into an uncomfortable situation and Brother Quang was reading him over
out.
And over, those down tilt pokes, he got so much mileage. That was excellently played from Brother Quang there.